Good morning, everybody. My name is Francesco Ripanti, and I am a PhD candidate at the University of Pisa. My research aims at understanding the participation of the public in Italian archaeology, and especially in ongoing excavation projects, through quantitative and qualitative analysis. Although my interest is not only focused on volunteers, I'm going to briefly present some insights developed from data that may be of interest from this session. Volunteers are defined as people who does work without being paid for it, because they want to do it. Moreover, they are those people already interested in archaeology who may strengthen the relationship between archaeology and society, acting as a mediators with those segments of the public more distant from archaeology. In Italy, we tend to consider volunteers as a monolithic body, as a group of people who are passionate about archaeology and they want to be involved. This idea lays at the root of the regulation and the promotion of the involvement of volunteers. And I believe that we need to focus more on understanding the possibilities of interaction and their meaning. So let's see. Let's see the three examples of participation of volunteers in archaeology in my research. My three case studies are Mastacciuccoli Romana, Poggio del Molino, and Vignale. And they are three Roman sites located in Tuscany. Poggio del Molino and Vignale are archaeological excavations, ongoing archaeological excavation, while Mastacciuccoli Romana is a small archaeological area recently excavated. In different contexts, in different ways, all of them organizes outreach activities, from guided tours to theatrical performances, sportive events, and so on. And the stakeholder analysis recently conducted shows that different kinds of volunteers have an interest in each site. Probably the most common way of involving volunteers in archaeology is excavation. At Poggio del Molino, most of the volunteers who participate in the project are provided by the American NGO Earthwatch. They pay for experiencing a period with archaeologists, supporting them in non-technical operations related to excavation. They usually choose to come to Poggio del Molino for learning the basics of archaeology. And since they are not Italian speakers, supporting outreach activities as guided tours would be very difficult. They only take part in non-technical operation related to excavation. According to the field director, one limitation to the program concerns the recent ordinance of the ministry that prohibited the involvement of volunteers in excavation, in technical operation related to excavation. The second example shows a different situation. At Vignale, volunteers are the member of local association and single persons. They spend their spare time supporting archaeological outreach with the aim of promoting the project who is investigating their local history. Without their help, for the archaeologists, it would be impossible to set up any outreach activity, any complex outreach activity. For example, last year, Giuseppe, that is the man here in this photo, took the initiative and planned an event on two consecutive days. Giuseppe is a resident of Follonica, a small city near the excavation. This event was organized as a conference in the city hall of his hometown, Follonica, and a guided tour at the archaeological site the day after. His target were the members of the Università della Libertà, a special university for elder people. Archaeologists were glad to extend their public to this new segment, only reachable with the help of Giuseppe. And Giuseppe was proud to make people aware of this excavation conducted in their territory. The last example refers to another way of conceiving volunteering. At Mastacciuccoli, since the end of excavations 7 years ago, to summer 2017, the small archaeological area has been managed by the local archaeological society, Gruppo Archeologico Massarorese, from now on GAM. GAM is mainly composed of local people who are very passionate in taking care of and in promoting the archaeological area. For them, it was like a second house. They used to organize many original initiatives with the help of a scientific director. In the focus group conducted with some members, they stressed their affection to the area, and as you can notice from the word of Gino, they emphasized their work as a team. Each member has his own role, and starting from his own expertise, contributed to the organization of the event. So, wrapping up these examples, we can notice that volunteers are single persons, each one with distinctive interests in and attitudes to archaeology. The historical value, the capability of the site to convey a relation to the past, is common to all the interviewees in the three case studies. Moreover, at Poggio del Molino, American volunteers want to learn the basics of archaeology, emphasizing an educational academic value. However, at Massaciuccoli Romana and Vignale, volunteers are based in the territory, and they have the chance to support and propose outreach activities. This interaction is directed at enhancing the social value, defined as the capability of the site to provide a place for social gatherings, and the cultural value, so the capability of the site to build affiliation in the present. We agree that all volunteers take the initiative of doing something, and as reported in the interviews, they have a plurality of interest. This is the core of their participation in archaeology. Engaging themselves in activities tailored on their interests, they start a personal meaning-making process, and at the end, they will have a story to tell. This story probably would be not relevant for the archaeologist, but will be the memory of the experience for volunteer. Last week, I was with archaeology at the Roman site, and thank you very much for your attention.